Felipe Lobos.
Fantasma. From now on, I need you to distribute double the amount of coin. The moment I detect disloyalty.
Felipe Lobos. He was a big antagonist through the first three seasons of the episode. Probably my favorite of all the quote-unquote villains in this series. And what a lot of people tend to forget is that the Jimenez cartel hated Lobos. They didn't like him. And a subscriber sent me something that could tie someone that we have been seeing to Lobos, because you know that crew probably still wants some heat for Ghost. And we're going to talk about it. But first, on this channel, we always put on the +7 glasses of sexy as hell, because I'm working on skilling my craft, bringing you a more informed YouTube experience, something better to look at. Please subscribe to my channel. Turn on those notifications so when I drop videos, you get them. Also, be sure to go to my YouTube homepage, scroll through my playlist. There's usually a video or a playlist for everybody. And check out my homie Mark Dart TV and Jay Moore. They've been doing power reviews for a very long time, and they do good work. This subscriber said, y'all missing out. The Serbs don't want Ghost whacked out, most of them. I think the cartel still has an inside person. I think that inside person is Rodriguez, Blanca. Rodriguez, she's trying to get Angie to turn just to find out who killed Lobos so they can get who did it. Sandoval is X, out of dead. Now the cartel needs answers. I think that is a hell of a theory that Blanca Rodriguez could be working for Felipe Lobos' cartel, because you guys know he had a cop that was working with the FBI back in the day. The only difference is now Rodriguez works for the police department. Now that particular FBI guy that Angela had sex with last season, I thought that he might be some kind of inside plant. But it is looking more and more to me that this Blanca Rodriguez could be a plant for Felipe Lopez and his crew. Now, if you guys don't remember Felipe, you guys can remember in season 1, Tommy and Ghost met up with him and they showed them doing their drug products, blah, blah, blah. And Ghost lets Felipe know he wanted out of the good drug game and doesn't like that idea. And eventually tells Ghost, you're not getting out this thing because you can be the biggest drug dealer. Then season 2, you know, Kanan comes in, released from jail, tells Lobos he wants Ghost dead. Lobos is later arrested, sent to prison. Tommy and Lobos' bodyguard is shot by the FBI. Ghost later comes to assassinate some of the drug gang leaders, Vladimir, Ruiz, and he sends Ruiz to disappear. But then eventually Lobos has a mobile phone. He contacts Tommy and tells Tommy to kill Ghost or else they're gonna kill Holly. And y'all know how that one went. Then in season 3, when they actually did kill Lobos, y'all know they broke him out of jail, Tommy and Ghost did, took his ass in the woods. Lobos, I think he cut Ghost and then Ghost shot him dead. Lobos is done, but no vengeance has been seen since that point. And this is where we get to Blanca Rodriguez. She could possibly be an inside plant for Felipe Lopez's cartel, because no vengeance has been served yet. And if she's not the inside plant, who is? The Rico Suave dude that Angela screwed in season 5? I think this is a hell of a theory that Rodriguez could be an inside plant, but I wanna know what you guys think. And I also wanna know, who was you guys' favorite villain out of all these seasons? Felipe Lobos was my favorite one. His queer ass, his man loving ass, his girl loving ass. He was just queer and weird, which created a great dynamic for that character. And I really liked the way they done him. And I just think that there is somebody that's gonna go all the way back to season 3, linking to the Lobos cartel, that's gonna show their head in season 6. And that person might very well be Blanca Rodriguez. That's gonna do it for this video. Don't forget to like my video. Please comment, subscribe, go get yourself a life gain. Leave me all your power theories. I will post some of them up here on YouTube for the world to see. And until that next sexy as hell power video. I'll see you.